Hello everyone. Today we will cover the topic cyclic redundancy check. So cyclic redundancy check. Cyclic codes are special linear block codes with one extra property. In a cyclic code, if a code word is rotated, means if a linear code is rotated by one bit, then it will result in the another code. This is the basic property of cyclic codes. A cyclic redundancy check is an error detecting code used to detect errors. In this, we append or we augment some extra bits to detect errors. Here you can see CRC encoder and the decoder. In the left hand side, you can see CRC encoder which work at the sender side. So first of all, you can see the data word of 4 bits A3, A2, A1 and A0. This data word is passed to the generator, and it is also generator is also provided with 4 bits divisor. So divisor have 4 bits D3, D2, D1 and D0, and also 4 bits of data words. Now 3 extra bits are augmented, which are called as augmented bits to data word. In this, it is not fixed, only 3 bits will be augmented. This depend on the size of divisor. So some extra bits are augmented to data words, and division process take place at generator side, and the result of division, or sorry, remainder of the division, which is known as remainder, and is augmented to the code word R2, R1, R0. And now this 4 bits of data word along with remaining bits of remainder and known as the code word. So here you can see if divisor have 4 bits, so remainder is having 3 bits R2, R1 and R0. Now this A3, A2, A1, A0 along with R2, R1, R0 is known as code word, and now this is transferred to the unreliable medium, and now this is sent to the receiver side. Now decoding process will take place at the receiver side. Now this code word is transferred to the another checker, another process known as checker, and this checker is also provided with 4 bits divisor. Now the division process will again take place at the checker side, and now the remainder of checker will be known as the syndrome. Now some decision logic will apply to this syndrome, and if this decision logic will decide that the code word will be, or sorry, data word will be accepted or the discarded. Now we will learn this logic through a numerical. Here you can see we are given with a data word 1001, and we are also provided with a divisor 1011. Now here you can see 1011 and the data word 1001. Now as we know, we have to append or we have to augment some bits to this data word. So how many bits will be augmented will depend on the number of bits in the divisor. As we know, divisor is having 4 bits, so the number of bits will be augmented is 1 less than number of bits in the divisor. So divisor is having 4 bits, so bits will be augmented are 4 minus 1, that are 3. So 3 bits are augmented here. Now 4 plus 3, 7 bits are of dividend and 4 bits are of divisor. Now the division will take place, but here one thing to remember is it division will be based on modulo 2 arithmetic. So first 4 bits 1001 will be divided by 1011, and modulo 2 arithmetic is based on XOR operation. So if both bits are same, the remainder will be 0, and if both bits are different, the remainder will be 1. So in the first step, remainder we generated is 00 it's 0, 01 XOR are 1, 11 XOR is 0, and now the value remains are 010, and 10 is borrowed from the dividend. Now we are having 0100, and as it can't be divided by 1011, so one more zero is borrowed from the dividend, putting zero in the quotient part. So we are having 1000 in the dividend part, and now this will be divided by 1011 in 1. So we are having 011, again 10 is borrowed, and now no more zeros are left in dividend. So this 110 will work as the remainder. Now data word will remain as it is, and this remainder, these 3 bits of remainder will augmented, and now data word along with remainder will known as the code word. Now this code word will be transmitted to the receiver. Now we will see the process of decoder at the receiver side. In the left hand side, you can see now the same division process will take place here. So 1001, 110, now this will be divided by 1011. Again, XOR division will take place, and in the first step, 1001, four initial 4 bits of code word is divided by 1011, leaving the quotient 1, and now the result is 010. 1 will be borrowed from dividend. Now the values are 0101. As 0101 can't be divided by 1011, so one more 1 will be borrowed, and now leaving the quotient 0. Again, 1011 is fully divisible by 1011, so it will be divided by 1, and the remainder will be 0. Again, 10 will be borrowed, and now the result will be 000, and this is known as the syndrome. So remainder in the or syndrome is 0. This is the concept. This is the concept of decision logic. If the division process, if the code word is divided by divisor and the result is or remainder is 0, remainder is also known as the syndrome. If the syndrome is 0, then the data word will be accepted. Otherwise, you can see in the right hand side, the same division process is take place. But here in you can see code word is changed by 1 bit. Instead of 1001, it turns out to be 1000110. So 4th bit of code word is corrupted when we transfer the code word on the unreliable transmission media. So the 4th bit is interrupted, or 4th bit is corrupted, and now this turned out to be 1000110. Now the at the checker side, same division process is taking place, and when we compute the syndrome, instead of coming 0, it turns out to be 011. So we know that syndrome is not 0. That's why data word will be discarded at the receiver side. You can see this at the black color. Now you can see one more example. Here we are given with the data word. It is clearly written that you are provided with the data word 10100110, and you are also provided with a divisor 10111, and we have to compute the code word. So one thing we have to remember, that the augmented bits will be 1 less than the bits in divisor, so 4 bits will be augmented here. Same XOR arithmetic process will take place, and the remainder comes out to be 0001. Now the data word along with 4 bits of remainder will work as the code word, and that will be our answer. Now what will happen at the receiver side? Now at the receiver side, this code word is divided by the same divisor, that is 10111, and same arithmetic process, that is modulo 2 arithmetic process, is take place, and remainder or syndrome is 0. As we know, at the decision logic, if the syndrome parts turn out to be 0, then only the data word will be accepted. So this data word will be accepted here. Now till now we have done this process using a binary division. Okay, one more concept is here. We can use the cyclic code using polynomial also. So we can use a polynomial to represent our binary word. Each bit from right to left is mapped onto a power term. As we know, a polynomial is having power more than 2, etc. So the rightmost bit represents the zeroth power term. The next will be 1, then again 2, and so on. If the bit is of zero value, then that power will be discarded. I will explain you using a numerical. So we have to divide a data word, that is x cube plus 1. So what is the difference here from the previous example? In the previous example, we are provided with 1001. Okay, and now here we are provided with a data word x cube plus 1. So in the previous, we are given with a binary word, and in the here we are provided with a polynomial word. So what is the concept here? 1001 can be written in polynomial. How it can be written? Rightmost one is denoting power of zero. So x naught is 1. Then again, 1001. So x1 multiply by 0. So x1 does not here. Again, x2 is again 0. And at last, x3 is 1. So that 1001 turns out to be x cube plus 1.